Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. Oh yeah, we're painting again. And this time I've got this scene of the sea. And I quite liked it. I quite like the way the shade sort of makes this dark, of course. And then lightens this up. These waves coming in. I just really liked it, so... Of course, I took a snap and for a potential painting for YouTube or for my pleasure. So here we are. Let's have a go at this. And quite excited about this, actually. Just kind of like those red bits in there. I always see more colour the more I look. If you was going to follow along with me and you want to use the image, you can take a still of the image and then... print it out or whatever, put it on your iPad, whatever modern things you've got. Have a hologram of it, whatever, and then go back in time and use a piece of chalk. I like using the chalk though. Gives me the opportunity to go get my horizon in. It should be right. Maybe not quite. Is that high enough? Might go a bit higher. Because this canvas size is different to this. This is just an A4 printout, so... Yeah. We have got lots of room there, really. Then I need to make the sky more interesting, don't I? If I'm going to do this. Let's carry on. We'll carry on. Just carry on. Anyway. What kind of angle is that? Angle. It's not as sharp as I thought it was at first. I thought it was a lot sharper than what it is. It's probably like this. And you've got this nice thing that's coming across there. Got the beach. Right there, and then we've got more behind the that one. We've got another set of waves coming in. Yeah, that's about right. Something like that, and then we've got this. Got this cliff, which is beyond halfway. I think we'll go for there. I might make it more dramatic than it is. Mainly because I've got a bit more room on the canvas and I can do that. I can dramatise things and make things bigger. There's a wall there. Maybe instead of just an old wall, maybe we could put a tower in there as well, maybe. Maybe those are not. You can make something up, I don't know. We can do that. Just to make things the way we want them to be. Use some of the realism of the picture and then use some of our imagination. That's the way I like doing paintings, actually. Use a bit of both of imagination and reality. So that'll do for our little sketch, I think. And then we can start putting in some sky and clouds and all sorts. All sorts. So I dug this knife out of all my stuff and my art stuff. And I was like, maybe I could use that. But I'm so used to using a brush now. I don't know if I will use it. But I've put it out. So the potential of using a knife is there. I don't want to never use it. Hasn't fulfilled its destiny, has it? If I never use it, I never use that knife. Will never fulfill its destiny of being painted with. Just wiping some of my brushes, getting them ready for action. Just dipped in oil. Linseed oil and oil of cloves. Right, so put in the sky first. As my mind darts around, I might get a little bit of cerulean there. Sky blue. I can't see any at hand. None at hand. I'll just use ultramarine blue, I think. So, my colours are ultramarine blue, alizarin crimson, burnt sienna, yellow ochre, cadmium yellow, titanium whites. I've put two because I know they get muddied so easily, so I'll put a bit out there. We'll make our sky. Still feel like it should have a bit of air. Cerulean blue. I knew I had some. Some cerulean blue as well. I want to use that for my sky. This is perfecto. There's a bit of white in there. As we go to the horizon. I'm liking these brush strokes actually. Kind of like a rough brush stroke. It's happening because my white is so weird. It's sort of a little bit icky, but I'm alright with that because it's making my paint behave in that way. It's giving my sky some nice action. Bit of a cloud there. Good cloud in here as well. this fake thing. Whatever it is. There we go. There's our sky. I'm going to leave them brush strokes on purpose because I like it. I'm going to grab a little bit of crimson and white. A little white as well. I'll leave it like that. That's a bit of this here as well. Far away there. Okay, I'll leave it at that, I think. It's quite good. I quite like it, actually. Now, I might get some brown, burnt sienna, yellow ochre. Burnt sienna, yellow ochre, I just want to start blocking in a little bit these shapes. And then what we could do with it as well. I didn't put any burnt umber on my palette. That's good to make my darks. Let's put some on now. Wiping that just to fill in that area. Now we can have some fun with these browns. I might do quite a strong burnt sienna, strong in it. It's tough. It's a strong one. So I'm going to get some dark as well. Some burnt umber and ultramarine blue. Make a nice dark. Maybe put a bit of red in it just to warm it up. And some dark areas. The light's not quite getting it. In. And we've got this fake tower. It just makes stuff up, don't bother. Put some different brush strokes in there, the yellow. To it. turns dark, it goes down on it. And yellow, white and yellow ochre, and we can start playing with this a bit. Some light, sunlight is sort of hitting this way, isn't it? So I'm going to put a bit there, some bits here and there, something's going along. On that side of that building, the fake building. That wall. Some of the some of that in. Some of that there. Got some it's all going dark. I'm going to drag that light upwards so it goes all the way up there. Yeah, it's quite good. Quite like that sort of cliff looking. Gonna get some yellow, a bit of that blue, a bit of brown in it. Gonna get some of this green in here as well. Just sort of hints of it. See some light. And some burnt sienna, some yellow ochre, and some white. I just want to pull out some more lights in areas like there. Something like that. Go back into my burnt sienna. Just add a bit more dark. Gotta remember, this is going to be quite far away. I don't want to go too crazy on it because. I don't mind that actually, as it is. Probably could do with a hint of light down here. I think that'll do. Got enough colours and a bit of something. There's a bit of something there. I think I'll put a bit more blue in that gap there. Just so it looks more like a something that's been ruined. And it's just like a shell of something. Yeah, I quite like that. Now, I've got a huge blob of blue on my arm. Putting it in the sea. So it's quite dark at the back end of the sea and it gets a bit lighter. So what I find works for me is to find a colour that is mostly in an area. So, for instance, like this area, if you squint down your eyes, you'll see like a sort of a light bluey, there's a bit of crimson in it, it's quite light, and it's worth blocking that whole thing in that colour, and then the one behind it is darker, and the same goes for that, I think. Block it in. So it's sort of along here. This is just ultramarine blue. Trying to get it straight. One way of doing it is using the basic easel to go like a robot going along. Keeping your finger on your easel. That's not bad actually. I'm going to use a bit of sky colour down there. I for that bit. It's a bit of rock here. It's a bit of light on it as well. There we go. Something like that. Yeah, so that'll do for that. And then, like I said, that colour before, it's probably almost this colour. Crimson, white. Crimson, white and blue. We are really, really close, actually. It is a really close colour. It's probably a touch bluer. We'll put it in. Bit of that colour in between the waves as well. There's a couple of waves there. Okay. So I'm trying to keep things thin still, so I don't want anything to go too strong too soon. My white needs a little bit of yellow in it. Put in a bit of yellow ochre because it doesn't want to be pure white, it wants to be have a warm goldness to it, so yellow ochre will do nice. We've got our little splashes coming. Wave goes along there. You can let some of it go into that blue behind. It's alright. And there's another wave right in front then. End. Just give the illusion of depth in there. You can splash. You can see the little waves in there, actually. That'll do. You can also see in areas you can see transparency. So a bit of the that's sand. You can see sand in there. up. And then seal all that. Quite like that, actually. We've got the sand at the base, which has paint on as well, but I want to get that waving first. So yellow ochre and white again. Just load your brush. One side, loads of paint, and then got that wave coming along here. It wants to be flat, so we're going sort of missing a bit of brown there, so we can get that in. Couldn't resist it. Kept seeing this area, and I wanted to put that in there. Kept looking at it like, oh, I want to paint that. There we go. And we've got this wave going. Sort of bring it around down. Pull some of that back there. There it is, you can see it all. Little colour. I might get a little bit more of the pure white on my brush just to make some changes of white water. See a wave sort of going along there as well. So when you're watching this, don't think this is the only way to paint water, to get that effect of water. There is all different ways, and when you're doing yours, you can do it in a different way to what I'm doing. It's all about having fun with it. I just want a little bit more of the sky colour in this area. Down here. be fair. That sort of lavendery purple colour works quite well underneath our water to make it stand out a little bit. A bit more sort of curling over here, because this is like where we're closest. Some bits in the transparent parts of the wave. Splashing going on there. There's a little light here in the foam. Some of this sienna, burnt sienna and burnt umber. These little streaks going along. Look at that shape there. There is a lot of, a heck of a lot detail that I'm missing out. And you choose what you want to put in and what you don't want to put in when you're painting. You can choose to put in less detail or more detail. That's up to you. Sort of sitting back having a look. Seems a bit more shape there. Oop. See, I'm purposely not going as bright as these. I don't want to destroy that effect of them being a lot brighter. Added a bit more to to the shape of that, really. That'd be nice. Get some light blue colour. Maybe dark as well. I'm gonna get some more depth into this bit of the water. It's a little bit just needs a bit more to it, I think. Pick the crimson and the blue. Just breaks it up a little bit. Yeah, I prefer that. You could add a little bit of light in this. Why not? I quite like that. Darken some of these areas underneath and make the wave a little bit brighter. Just sort of sit back, have a look at that. Always, yeah, quite like that. What I might do is add a bit of a splash, a bit more of a splash, I should say, hitting there, in that background. Splashes here and there. But yeah, I think that'll do. Quite like that. It's very, it's got a lot of energy coming. It's got a lot coming at us, maybe, as well. A bit of light in the wave back there. Something like that. I think I'll call this one just about finished. I might put a bird in. That's what I'm thinking of, because I always see a lot of birds at the coast. It's one thing I like about the seaside, all the seagulls and things. It's great, isn't it? I might put a a bit of a rubbish brush, but maybe we could make it work. Maybe there's a seagull there. on there. Just flying by. Yeah. Enjoyed myself there. I hope you enjoyed watching this one. I'm tempted to go into more detail along this bit here. Some little bits here and there. I think maybe a little there. Yeah. I think we'll call it finished there. Put myself a little JB on the corner using this dodgy brush. Because I've had it stood in oil, it's lost its shape. There we go. So thanks very much for watching this episode. Hope it gave you some ideas. And hopefully I'll see you another one. Cheers. Bye.